Hello everybody, my name is Baird Thompson, and today on How to Baird, I want to talk to you a little bit about my work experience, as well as a few more announcements. My work experience has been pretty crazy. There's been ups and downs, but I think that it's been a very valuable experience for me overall. My first job was at McDonald's when I was just 15 years old. I realized that I didn't have the money to pay for a phone. I didn't have the money to pay for all the nice things that I wanted, like video games. At least that's what I wanted at the time. And McDonald's was a perfect way to start that off. Let me just tell you that it is not the easiest job, but it is the best job I think I could have had to be my first job. It taught me a lot about banking. It taught me a lot about working and the environment and how you're going to have to deal with some people who you may not agree with on how to do things. And I learned a lot of valuable lessons through working at McDonald's. I learned that there's going to be some early mornings and some late nights apart from school days. And I learned that I had to be dedicated and on time. And I also learned a lot about banking. I learned after opening a bank account that I needed to save. So I saved 50% of all of my money that I made from McDonald's and gave 10% to God. And I found that this was actually helping me to prepare for the future. I was going to be able to use that money for college eventually. So that was McDonald's. My second experience after McDonald's was at the North Museum of Nature and Science. Now, you may be wondering how I got a job at the North Museum of Nature and Science. Well, let me explain a little bit to you. My advisor to astronomy club and to astronomy classes and so on saw the job position opened, and he said, "Hey Baird, I think you should apply for this. You already have the knowledge of the planetarium and the sky and the stars and what is beyond." And I said, yeah, this would be a great idea. And this actually taught me how to make a resume, how to make a cover letter, all of these things that go into a more professional job. And this taught me a lot about the professional work world. And I was very privileged to have been able to get a job there. So when I was working there, I was teaching astronomy in the planetarium to other guests, and not just astronomy, I was also teaching other forms of sciences. So I really, really enjoy working at the North Museum. That's only one weekend out of every month, so it allows for other time, for other jobs and activities, of course, and I really appreciate the experience that I've had there. And then I also picked up a job then at Burger King. Burger King was a smaller job that I knew I wasn't going to do too much with. I just knew that it would be nice to have an extra few hours per week that I could rely on to bring in even more income. And then I found, well, I can actually make money off of things that I enjoy to do more so. Now, of course, I do enjoy teaching astronomy and I do enjoy food service a lot. But my biggest passion is videography. My biggest passion is communications. And I took that passion that I had and decided that I would start to do some projects for different companies and do commercials and so on and so forth in order to bring in an income in that way. And that has been the most fun experience that I've had in working. And that has been something that I have just... I don't even know how to describe it. I really love videography, and that's why I'm making these vlogs. That's why I take the time to set up everything for this vlog and this set and everything. And I know that it's going to be worth my time later on when I pursue it as a career because I had all of this time that I put in to bettering myself. And that's the whole point of these vlogs. That's the whole point of doing those commercials. Yes, of course, I was making money, and I'm still making money from that. However, the biggest thing is just preparing myself for the future, making myself better, equipping myself with even more skills, and being able to move forward with videography. So as you can see, I have not taken off my uniform from Moe's. I just came home from a shift at Moe's, and I really, really enjoy Moe's. Moe's is a job that I just got probably 2 or 3 months ago now, and Moe's has been just incredible, seriously. Obviously, it has its ups and downs, but it is a pretty awesome environment. It's very friendly, and it is a place that is filled with energy. I mean, the fact that I was told that I have to say, "Welcome to Moe's," every single time that a customer came in, that's something that I was excited about. If you know me, you know that I love to have energy and to be loud. I'm a loud person. I own that, and I love it. And I love that I can go to Moe's outside of being at home or being at school, and those places I'm told you have to be quiet and so on and so forth. But at Moe's, I can yell out, "Welcome to Moe's." Heck, sometimes I even sing "Welcome to Moe's" when I'm there, and my other coworkers laugh at me for it, and it's hilarious, and I just really enjoy it. I originally got that job because I walked into a Moe's in Centerville, and I heard somebody say, "Welcome to Moe's," to me, and I was like, "Whoa, is that a requirement? That's pretty cool." And this was the first time that I'd ever been at Moe's, and so I went in, and I got a really delicious quesadilla. And I went down the line and I spoke to a man who was at the register who was actually happened to be the general manager. And then I asked him, I said, "Hey, are you guys hiring? I would love to be able to contribute to this environment." And in reality, that was the truth. That wasn't even close to a lie, because I just love the energy of Moe's. There is even a plaque that says that Moe's is G-rated. And I think that that's awesome because I think that that promotes an environment that's healthy for families and for coworkers to be able to. It's just a very conducive environment for productivity and for kindness, and I really enjoyed that idea about it. So I went in the next day for an interview and immediately was hired, started a few days later, and I absolutely loved Moe's. Just going down the line, it's basically a Subway, but with Southwest food. And so I really enjoyed that experience. I moved over to the Lititz location, which is where I now am, and I really, really enjoy that. The people are just so friendly, it's so kind all the time, and we make jokes with each other, and at the end of the day, it's all just a good time. And so I really like the family. It's basically a family. I mean, there are pictures of everybody on the wall in near the office, and it's just a really cool experience, and it has been so far for me. And I look forward to what it brings in the future. I look forward to meeting new people there and working with the people that are there now. And so, yeah, shout out to everybody from Moe's. That has been my experience with working. I have worked at McDonald's, the North Museum, Burger King. I've done a lot of videography work, and of course, I'm still working at Moe's now. And I'm looking forward to all that my future holds. I'm looking at careers right now in videography and potentially the food business, and I am really excited for where God is going to take me because I know that there is a lot of potential in both of those areas. And that because I am a hard worker, that I will be able to excel and go above and beyond and hopefully be able to achieve a lot of good work and be able to help a lot of people. And that's ultimately my goal. So, yeah, thank you for listening in for just a little bit of my experience with work. Again, this is just a way for me to document all of this for later in life. When I want to look back at what it was like for me when I was a teenager, and of course, to give myself more experience, and if you're interested, to learn more about myself. On a
This
cold
camera's just filming everything I'm
winter.
doing right now. I'm gonna be so mad.
That'd be a waste of my SD card.
Okay.
It's gonna be great, fam.
Yes.
What?
Crispy.
Crispy. Let
Crispy.
me test audio. Say stuff. Speak a little louder. Louder. Now go back to what you originally did. A little bit louder. Do it again. Great, fam, great. Yanks.
Yanks.
What'd you just do? Do it again.
I'm like...
What the heck?
It's called the monkey.
Alright, yo, you about to cry. Alright, you're legit about to cry.
Got it.
Caleb Nation, it's time, boys. It is time. There it is.
Alright, that was weird. So, why'd
you
do that?
It was around December 25th, you know. Heard this song. This is so good. Such a great melody. Lyrics weren't exactly doing it for me. So, you know, maybe thought I'd switch it up a bit. Yeah. Maybe add something to
I'm not
song.
A good actor. Caleb should act. I want to see you in here, Caleb.
No, I want you to do it.
Whoa. You can do that, though.
That's not part of the shot. Instead. Ooh, that's straight fire.
This is hard.
Oh,
damn! Yes! It's literally trash, but with a purpose.
This has been a how-to bear review.
So Caleb, you're from Hawaii, right?
Yeah, I am. It's pretty sweet, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, like...
Trying, dude! This is hard, bro!
Alright, this is the hardest thing I've ever had to do in my life. This is literally the most stressful thing I've ever done in my entire life. Okay? Don't laugh. I swear if you laugh, we have to do this again.
Question after waking up from being frozen for 100 years be like, what would your like yeah, you're frozen for 100 years, what would be your first question when you wake up?
Where's the bacon?